everyone. In this video, we are going to answer a question which is, why do objects float or sink? Now, in the previous videos, we have already seen a few things. That is, when we place an object in the surface of a fluid, then there are a few forces which are acting on it. The first one is due to the weight of this object, that is the gravitational force. And the second force is the buoyant force which this fluid exerts onto the object. And these two forces are in opposite directions to each other. Now, we have learned that if the weight of the object is greater than the buoyant force offered, then the object sinks. And in the second case, if the weight of the object is equal to the buoyant force, then the object floats. And the third case, when the object has a weight which is lesser than that of the buoyant force, then the object completely floats on the surface of the fluid. So this is what we have already seen. Now, let's say we have a wooden block which is cubical in shape like this, and let's say I want to cut a piece of wood from this huge block, and that piece must be cubical in shape and also must have a volume of 1 cm³. Now, to cut that, I will first mark a cubical piece over here and then cut it out. Now, this cubical piece of wood or this small block of wood has a volume of 1 cm³, as I have measured already, and this piece of wood also has some sort of mass. Now, when we zoom this block, then we find there are millions of particles stacked one above the other like this to form this small unit volume cubical block. So this is nothing but the matter that is contained in this wooden block. Now, the amount of this matter which is contained in this wooden block, which is of unit volume, is what we call as the density of that particular object. So, the density of a material is given by its mass per unit volume. That usually means that when we take out a unit volume of that particular object, then how much amount of matter or mass is contained in that particular small volume of the object. And that's what we call the density of that object. Now, density of an object is also a property of the object, which is given by mass divided by volume, or mass upon volume. So this is the formula by which we can calculate the density of any object. Now, the SI unit of density is kg/m³, and also it is measured in terms of g/cm³. Now, here in this table, I have shown the densities of different substances. Here, in this column, I have listed the substances, different substances, and in this column, I have listed out the density of these substances. Now, there are a few things to notice in this table over here, that the density of air here is the least one, that is 0.0013 g/cm³. And when we go downwards, while we go downwards in this table, we find that the densities of the substances increase. So I have placed the substances in the increasing order of their densities in this table. So when we see the next member of this column, that is cork, which has a slightly greater density as compared to air, which is 0.24 g/cm³. That essentially means that when we take a centimeter cube volume of cork, we will be having 0.24 grams of matter contained in that small volume or unit volume. Now, next member is wood, which has a density of somewhere ranging between 0.43 to 0.85, depending upon the type of wood we choose. Next member is the ice, which has a density of 0.93 g/cm³. And the next member is water, which has a density of 1 g/cm³. Now we see that as we go downwards, we have some metals listed over here like aluminium, iron, silver, mercury and gold, which all have densities which is greater than that of water. And in this table, the highest density is given by gold, which is 19.3 grams per centimeter cube. And the next highest is of mercury, which is 13.57 grams per centimeter cube. So in this table, the things which are listed above water have a density which is less than that of water. And the things that are listed down below water have densities which are greater than that of water. Now this property of all the substances, that is density, plays a vital role in when it comes to floating or sinking of an object. So here, basically here, the answer to our question lies. Now let's take the first case, that is if the density of the object is less than that of the fluid that we have taken. Now let's take the fluid to be water. And we have also already seen that what are the substances which have a density which is lesser than that of water in the table that we have seen before. Now let's take wood first of all. Now when we place a block of wood on the surface of water, it floats. And when we place a cork on the surface of water, again the cork floats. Now we have seen that the densities of wood and cork are less than that of water. And we see that these substances which have less density as compared to the fluid that we have chosen, then these objects float on the surface of the fluid. So from this we conclude that the object floats if its density is less than that of the fluid that we have chosen. Now let's look at the second case, that is the density of the object is equal to the density of the fluid chosen. Now we'll take the same fluid, that is water. Now there is one such substance which has a density which is very, very close to the density of water. And the substance is tar. Now when we place this tar on the surface of the water, it doesn't float, but on the surface of the water it doesn't float, but it still floats. But in a different way, as we can see from the figure here. Now when the object has a density that is equal to that of water, it floats, but it floats in such a way that all of its mass remains submerged in water and no part of it is exposed to air, or no part of it remains above the surface of the water. But in this case, this material doesn't sink down to the bottom of the vessel, but it stays afloat all the time. Now let's look at the third case, when the density of the object is greater than the density of the liquid that we have chosen. Now we'll choose the same liquid, that is water. And from the table we know that what are the objects which have a density which is greater than that of water. We have listed some metals like aluminium, iron, mercury, silver and gold to have densities which are greater than that of water. So we can test this using those materials, or some of these those materials. Now let's say we have an iron nail placed on water. We see that it straight away sinks down to the bottom. And when we repeat the same procedure with a ring made up of gold, we again find that it sinks down to the bottom. Now here we see that the objects sink when their densities is greater than that of the fluid that we have chosen. So here in this video, basically we have learned that how the density of the solid object that we have chosen depends upon the buoyant force that the water or any other fluid exerts onto the object. So we have also seen that depending upon the density of the object and the density of the fluid that we have chosen, the object will either float or sink into the bottom. And if the density of the object is less than that of the fluid, then the object floats. And when it is greater than that of the fluid, then the object sinks. So I hope this video was helpful to you and it was meaningful to you. Thanks for watching.
TutorialsPoint.com. Simply easy learning.